Hi kids, it's me Angel. Welcome back to another Sunday service here at the Movement Kids. How are you all doing today? I hope that you are all doing well. So, who's ready to have some fun, do some lively worship, and also learn more about God's Word today? I know I am, so don't go anywhere, stay tuned, and learn more about God's Word.
Stomp your feet, clap to the rhythm of the scuffle timby. Jump to the left, jump to the right. We're gonna have fun as we learn about Christ. He's bigger, better, stronger, greater. He helps me in all I do. Now it's time to celebrate and do what the scuppets do. Left, la, 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 la. Right, la, 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 la. Spin around. You're doing real good, you're doing just fine. Keep moving to the rhythm one last time. Jump to the left, jump to the right. We're gonna have fun as we learn about Christ. He's bigger, better, stronger, greater. He helps me in all I do. Now it's time to celebrate and do what the scuppets do. Left, right, spin around.
Hey kids! Happy Sunday! Do you like my hat? Doesn't it look cool?
Yeah.
Do you like it?
Yes, I
like it. I don't think you like it.
Yeah, you look like fisherman.
Fisherman, right? That sounds cool. But anyway, we are about to worship God and we are gonna sing a very beautiful song, and it is called The Blessing. I think you have heard this everywhere on YouTube. Maybe you heard your parents sing this song as well before. But now, it is your turn to sing. So, are you ready? Let's get started. Lord bless you and keep you. Make His face shine upon you. Be gracious to you. Lord, turn His face towards you and give you peace. If you believe it, say amen.
It is for you, it is for you, it is for you.
we thank you for today. Thank you for your blessings in our life, God. We thank you for our families, for our parents, and for our friends, God. We thank you for internet that we can still watch all these videos, God Jesus, to learn more about the Bible every single day, God. We thank you and we pray that today you're going to speak to every single one of us. We want to learn more about you. We thank you, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Slapstick Theater. Paul and Felix. This is Paul.
Oh, hey.
Who told people about Jesus in lots of different places. Many of the Jews did not like what Paul was doing. So they made a plot to kill him. Since Paul was a Roman citizen, he was taken in by the Romans.
Oh.
So they could find out what the Jews had against him. Paul was sent to Felix, the governor at Caesarea. The Jews brought their case before Felix. They said that Paul was a troublemaker and was stirring up riots among the Jews all over the world. Then Paul got his chance to speak. He said that he was not stirring up trouble at all, and that these men couldn't prove the things they said of him. Paul said that he believed everything in the Jewish law, for he was a Jew himself and a follower of Jesus. Then Felix concluded the council and pushed it off until someone else could decide the case. He ordered Paul to be put in prison, but his friends could still visit him and take care of him. A few days later, Felix and his wife, who was a Jew, sent for Paul. Paul told them all about his faith in Jesus and the truth of what Jesus said. Felix became afraid and sent Paul away.
Go away!
For the next 2 years, Felix would call Paul before him and talk with him often. Felix hoped that Paul would bribe him, but that did not happen. After 2 years of this, Felix was replaced by a new leader. Felix wanted to gain favor with the Jews, so he left Paul in prison. Paul would go on to have many more trials, but through it all, he continued to speak the truth of Jesus.
Wow, what a great story that was! I'm sure we all learned a lot from the story. As you all know, for the past few weeks, we've been learning about the fruit of the Spirit. And today, we're going to learn about patience. So, what is patience? Patience is about our attitude. And patience is also being able to wait and deal with delay, trouble, or suffering without getting angry. Like from the story, even if Paul did nothing wrong, he was imprisoned. But what did he do instead? He did not get angry with God or anyone, but instead, he continues to pray and spread the word of God. Well, before we continue, let me get something to drink first, because I'm very thirsty. But I like something cold. Well, the Coke is not cold. I need some ice. Let's make some ice. Let's put this in the freezer. Alright, I'm back. While we wait for the ice, let's continue with patience.
A few moments later.
Oh, let's see if it's ready. Oh, I can't wait. I don't like not cold. Let's twist these. Oh, how do we twist? Oh no, 5 minutes is not enough. Oh, I think I need to wait a little bit longer. We are waiting for the ice because it is worth it. Because we like our drinks to be cold. Also, there are a lot of things in life that require patience. Maybe waiting in line for that roller coaster ride, or Christmas, or maybe our birthdays. So remember, patience doesn't come by accident. It comes when we prepare ourselves to be patient and by reminding ourselves that it is okay to wait, or it's okay if things don't go our way. So the next time when you feel impatient, just remember about the ice and it will be worth it. It's not easy, but if we keep practicing, it can be done. As Philippians 4 verse 6 says, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. So guys, before we close, let's pray together. Thank you, Jesus, for the beautiful morning. Thank you for the story and the message. Please help us to have more patience because we know that things that you plan is worth waiting for. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Okay guys, I hope you're blessed and enjoyed the video. And I'll see you next time. Bye.